Buenos días, gracias por compartir conmigo este nuevo día. Que sea bendecido. Mi nombre es Pastora Ramona Guadalupe. Este programa se llama Las Promesas de Dios. Este programa es en español, también en inglés. Vamos a estar mirando hoy el libro de Samuel, capítulo 68, versículo 5 hasta 6. Yo estaba en vacaciones y descanso. Y regresé para atrás para las promesas de Dios. Yo oro que tu verano fue lo más amable, bien bendecido. Y ahora como estamos empezando un nuevo tiempo y el Señor quiere que tú sepas que quiere que tú sigas con la palabra del Señor y conociéndolo Él. Hoy este tema es revolver a la casa del Señor. Vamos a coger este momentito y orar para que el Señor te vaya bendiciendo en este día. Señor Jehová, en el nombre de Jesucristo, yo oro, Jesús, que tú te recibas toda la gloria. Abre los corazones de tu gente, de tu pueblo, Señor Jesucristo. Que todo sea para tu gloria, Señor. Amén. I want to welcome you today, another blessed summer day. I was away on vacation too, and the station too, the staff in the station. But I'm glad to return back. My name is Pastor Ramona Guadalupe, and this program is called The Promises of God. If you're joining me for the very first time, I pray that you'll be blessed. The theme topic today is returning home. We're going to be looking at the book of the song that King David wrote. He was a poet. So he wrote many songs. So we're going to be looking at Psalm 68, verse 5 to 6. So let me take this moment and pray. And I do pray that God will bless you. Let me pray for you. Blessed Father, I pray for your people. I welcome you to be here. Let it be that you receive all the glory. I pray, Father, as your people, especially the students, are returning back to school, I pray that this program would help them out, Blessed Father, and that let it be spiritual food for them as they study in the state of Vermont and in this town, Middlebury, Vermont. I pray, Father, that they will receive the spiritual food, that it will help them while they are studying here. Not only for them, Blessed Father, for those who are watching this program from the four corners of the world, and especially the international viewers, that you will bless them, Blessed Father. Thank you, Father, for this platform, that let it be that you receive all the glory in Jesus' name. Amen. This program is a bilingual program, and returning back after being away a couple of weeks, I prayed and I have prayed that God will continue to bless you. So I will return back shortly and to translate. This program is 15 minutes in Spanish, 15 minutes in English. So it's a total of a half an hour. So again, join me from the book of Psalm 68, verse 5 to 6. Revuelve para atrás de la casa del Señor. Esto es el tema de hoy y va a ser la semana que viene. Esto en dos partes. Esta es la primera parte. Revuelve la casa. Revuelve en la casa de Dios. En el libro de Salmo 68, versículo 5 hasta el 6. Que habla que Dios es el padre de los padres, la gente que no tiene padres. Y él defiende las mujeres que no tienen esposo. Y Dios es santo de la familia del Señor, que siempre Dios está velando, y los que están prisioneros también. Y este es el Dios que nosotros estoy hablando, que Dios vela a su gente. En especial la vida, las mujeres que no tienen esposo, los esposos que no tienen esposa, y los que son pobres también, que no tienen casa. Dios es padre de los ancianos, de los que son de diferentes partes, que no son de la misma cultura. Dios siempre está velando El Dios, por eso es que es bien importante que nosotros llegamos a conocer quién es Dios. Como estamos pasando por este tiempo para Estados Unidos, que vamos a estar votando para un presidente para Estados Unidos en 2 meses y medio. El tema es de los ancianos y los extranjeros y los que no tienen padres o madres y los huérfanos también. Dios es Dios de todo. Él tiene un corazón para este grupo de gente. A veces otros, como estamos pensando quién va a ser el presidente de Estados Unidos, tenemos que mirar la madera de la persona. Los otros, cómo los otros los perdimos. Ya dejamos muchas cosas del Señor. Y el Señor quiere que se vuelva para atrás, para la casa del Señor, la casa de Dios y las maderas de Dios, porque Dios es un Dios justo. Dios dice, me dejaste y me diste la espalda, pero no me diste tu cara. Él quiere que nosotros revolvamos para atrás, para la casa del Señor, en las maderas de Dios. Porque Dios es un Dios justo, Dios siempre está pensando los que son pobres, los que no tienen una persona para defenderlo, pero los prisioneros también. Dios le pone coritos, canciones en los corazones, los que están en preso, no es necesario en preso en una cárcel, pero que están en preso cuando el mundo, la sociedad, que estamos caminando, que no se ocupan de los niños y no se ocupan de las mujeres que están solas, sin esposo, y los que no tienen padre, los varones, los esposos que no tienen esposa. Dios se ocupa de los extranjeros y los huérfanos. Él se ocupa, Él tiene un corazón especial para ellos. Jesús dice que nosotros los perdimos el camino. Aquí David, el rey David, está hablando que tenemos que, este es el Dios, que Dios es el Padre que los que no tienen Padre. Tú me puedes decir, pero pastora, ¿por qué tú me estás trayendo este tema? La razón que te traigo este tema es especial, como ya perdimos el respeto de ser humano. Ya los huérfanos, los que no tienen casa, los que no tienen para comer, los abandonamos, los niños, los maltratamos, los otros adultos. Ya los niños los tratan como un trapo, no solamente en este país, pero por la guerra, lo que está pasando en diferentes partes del mundo, que los niños están sufriendo. Dios es el Dios de los extranjeros, de los huérfanos, los pobres, los que no tienen mamá y su papá tampoco. Dios quiere que nosotros revolvamos para atrás. Por eso que los líderes que vamos a coger para presidente de este país, tenemos que ver qué los corazones de ellos, cómo ellos piensan de ser humano. No solamente porque si la persona no es rico, no tiene mucho dinero, no quiere decir que la persona no vale nada. Pero esto para cada persona, que tenemos que revolver la madera de Dios en la casa de Dios. Eso quiere decir todo los presidentes, el gobierno, todas las personas tenemos que vivir para atrás y hacer las maderas de Dios, porque dejamos en las maderas de Dios. Y Dios está llamando a cada persona que tenemos que revolver para atrás en la casa del Señor, quiere decir la madera de Dios, porque lo perdimos. Dios es Dios de los que no tienen padre, los que no es padre para todo ser humano, es especial los que no tienen su mamá, su papá. Él también es padre, los que están en la cárcel, canta el corito, los que reciben a Dios, a Jesucristo, el Salvador. Yo sé que este verano, lo que está pasando en Estados Unidos, en diferentes partes, no solamente Estados Unidos, pero diferentes partes de racismo con la policía y también lo que está pasando en Siria. Sabemos que el Señor está cerca, por eso es que el Señor manda a su mensajero para dejarte saber, porque las promesas son para ti. Las promesas son para que tú revuelves para atrás en la casa del Señor. Eso es el tema de hoy. El Señor quiere que tú vengas y recibe, que haga justicia en la corte, en la comunidad, dejando todo bochinche, porque Dios no le gusta que los vecinos están contra de cada uno. Pero porque estamos viviendo en tiempo corto, antes de la segunda venida de Jesucristo, Él quiere que tú venga para atrás en la casa del Señor. Venga para atrás y hacer la justicia, hacer las cosas como las maneras de Jesucristo. En el libro de Deuteronomy, que habla capítulo 16, versículo 14, que habla que Dios es el Dios de los huérfanos, el Dios de las viudas, el Dios de los pobres, el Dios de los que están en la cárcel, y el padre de los que no tienen padres. Tenemos que, querida y querido, tenemos que revolver para atrás al Señor, porque Dios poderoso quiere que nosotros caminamos en las maderas de Dios. Por eso que te invita a Él para revolver para atrás en la casa de Dios. ¿Qué vamos a decir? Estas son las promesas para ti, que Dios te ha dado a ti, como estamos viviendo en este tiempo, preparando los corazones para la segunda venida de Jesucristo, porque mira lo que está pasando, querida. ¿Y cómo no podemos hacer este revuelve para atrás y para la iglesia? Leer la escritura. Ya la escuela, la universidad, los estudiantes, algunos ya empezaron sus estudios en la universidad, los colegios y los high school, y ya los estudiantes están revolviendo para atrás. El Señor quiere que a todos los padres también que revuelven para atrás en la casa de Dios, y orar para los hijos de tus hijos, porque ya sabes con esta droga lo que está pasando, quitándole la vida a tus hijos. Por eso que los padres es bien importante. Y Dios dice, si no tienes padre, yo soy tu padre. Porque esas son las promesas que son para ti, querida y querido. Yo oro que en este nuevo tiempo, que los estudiantes están revuelven para atrás para la universidad y también para la escuela. Que el Señor te toque tu corazón, que cuente una iglesia y los padres. Dios oye esas oraciones para tus hijos cuando tú oras para el Señor. Tenemos que revolver para atrás el Señor, porque Dios es Dios de los padres de los que no tienen padre. Estas son las promesas para ti. En nombre de Jesús. Amén. I want to thank you for staying as I translate. The theme topic is coming back home, you know, to return back. To return back to the house of God. You might say, what do you mean, Pastor? See, God is a God that is calling each and every one of us each day and each time. He wants you to return back home to Him, into His ways, beloved. These are the promises that God has given to all of us, and He has given us choices. You know, beloved, our children are returning back to the university colleges, our local colleges, and those that are international students are coming into our towns and country and studying. But the theme topic is come back home. And our parents are worried about our children, especially with the drug epidemic that is going on in everywhere in our community, and even now that your children are going back to school. But I come to tell you, beloved, He wants you to come back. He wants you to get to know who He is. And I speak especially for those who feel like, well, I don't have a father. I don't have a mother. I am an orphan. I am a stranger. I am a foreigner. But do you not know that God has promised? As God has a special heart for the foreigners, for the orphans, for the widows, for the fatherless, those who are in prison, God has a special heart for you. You're not a throwaway in God's eyes. Especially our children, God has a special heart for the children. We live in a time, as many of you know, that our children are being abused by the hands of adults. We pray that our children will be protected now that they're going to school, a place of learning, that God will protect our children. When I say our children, all children are our children. That the teachers will know and respect the boundaries of the children that they are teaching. And that God will protect our children, our foreigners, and those children who are homeless, that are sleeping in cars or in shelter, that God will watch over them, because God has a special place in his heart and a special protection and defender of those who are foreigners, homeless, orphans, widows, and the poor, and the children itself. Beloved, as many of you know, that this summer now we are in a new season. Many are returning back to the things that they have done. The vacation is almost over. You know what has happened this summer with the police and you know, the abuse that is happening with the African Americans. Not only African American, but Latino too. I have to say that through your prayers, changes are coming to the United States with the police force, with establishment of those who have been oppressed, those who do not have any father or mother, and those who are homeless. There are changes that is happening right now. I want to commend the president of this country. This past Tuesday, many of the officers, police, chief of police, and other police commissioners have attended the White House for a meeting to what can we do to reform the attitude of police officers. I want to thank the Burlington police officers and even our local Middlebury officers. I do not know what's really going on with the Middlebury police officers, but I have to say that I'm pretty sure that the chief of police was one of those who participated in this Tuesday in the White House, Washington, D.C., with the president. I'm not sure whether they attended, but I know for sure that the Burlington, Vermont police officers, chief of police, did attend. We need to come to a medium. This has been a very difficult summer, especially we are in the process of electing a president in 2.5 months for the United States. We have to examine that, have we gone in our own ways, or are we turning into a path that is leading into destruction? Let's take a look. In the book of Psalm, King David, he was the second king for the Israelites, and he was a king that used to write poetry and songs. Matter of fact, he changed the praise to God. I mean, this is to this day, over 2,000 years, we are praising God because of King David in a way that has never done before he became king. He talks about here in the Psalm 68, a father to the fatherless, a defender of widows is God in his holy dwelling. God sets the lowly in the family. He heads. He leads out the prisoners with singing, but the rebellious live sunder land, in a dry land. You know, we all have a responsibility. I have my family, I'm an empty nester. My family's already grown. But I care for every child that is entering into school right now because of the drug epidemic. But I pray, and I have the God today, as I was coming here, I looked up in the sky and I saw beautiful clouds, puffy clouds. And I said, this is the God that I serve, the God that created those clouds and the beautiful blue sky behind those clouds. That's the God that I serve. Beloved, the promises are for you. Just like God is a defender of those who are oppressed, the orphans, the fatherless, the foreigners, God has a special heart for the foreigners. So God is calling back everyone. Come back home to his ways. Come back home to his house. Because when we come back to his house, we get to know God's way. You know, we've been praying for the police, the law enforcement, whether it's state, federal, or local. We've been praying for all people of color, for all people. But people of color have been oppressed and abused. This is why that is called for new changes. When we come back to God's way, come back home, we get to learn God's way, what God expects of us, and what he wants of us, especially if we are in leadership. God wants us to come back home, beloved, and learn his ways. God is a defender and the protector of those who are oppressed, the fatherless, the homeless, the orphanage, the widows, and the poor. God is the defender. So when God gives a position to someone or a group of people, we have to serve the people of God, the community, with trembling, fear and trembling. Because you become a servant of the living God. You know, beloved, I mentioned this before, my family had been in law enforcement, two members of my family, so I'm aware the difficulties of law enforcement, whether it's the president down to our local government, the governor, the state governor, the federal government, the president too, they all have to remember who are they serving. The people, they are serving, just like Jesus Christ is a servant to, was a servant to all of us. He expects us to treat one another with dignity and respect, because these are what God expects us. And God is a defender. These are the promises that he has given to us. So beloved, as we start this new season, there's several things that I'm giving you right now for the students, for God to protect all students with this drug epidemic. I pray that you come back home to God, to the house of God. I pray that you get to know his way, because once you get to know who God is, and every time you look up and you see the sun, the moon, the stars, the clouds, and the air that you breathe, that's the God that I'm talking about that created you. So we should treat one another with so much care and gentleness, beloved. So we continue. The reason why before I came here, matter of fact, right now, this moment, there's a group of clergy that we're getting together every month to discuss ways, how could we work together because as clergy, we are the peacekeeper in the community. Right now, they are gathering with the chief of police in Burlington, with the other clergy and officers. How can we integrate and help out the community, whether hiring people of color, whether hiring minority Latinos? We are working together, because the tapestry, like I mentioned many times, the tapestry of the United States already have changed. It's no longer European. So beloved, God is a God that cares. He's a defender. He defends our children. He defends the fatherless, the home, and those who are oppressed. So we have to continue as a community and peacemaker to work with the law enforcement, to work with the government, to work, you know, as civilian together. Because guess what? Everything is falling apart because we have abandoned God. He wants you to come back home. He's asking you to come back home to learn his ways. Because once you come back home, you learn who God is. And how do we learn who God is and what he expects from us? He expects of us to do justice, do what is right, speak truthfully to one another. So beloved, as returning back from a new season, I am hoping that every church around every four corners of the United States will be filled every Sunday and come and give God all the glory. Yes, everything is not a bowl of cherry. Things are not going to go your way all the time. But look at it this way, beloved. There are people right now in Louisiana, in Texas, in other parts of the United States that are suffering. They lost their home. What do we do? We give thanksgiving. You woke up this morning, you had water, you took a shower, you ate. The streets, the road, the highways are paved. Beloved, he wants you to come home and give him thanksgiving. So as this new season, embrace our high school students, our junior high school students, our elementary. Listen, be vigilant for them. If you see something, say something. Yeah, like they say in New York City, if you see something, say something. Protect our children. Parents, I know that you pray for your children every day. And God is in the business of hearing parents' prayers. So come back home. Bring your children to the house of God every Sunday. Yes, you might have your soccer ball or your whatever sport. But when you put God first, beloved, God will bless you and protect your family. You know, these are the promises of God. He wants you to come back home and do his ways. And it does not mean your problem is going to go away. But what it does is God will help you to deal with whatever circumstances. And beloved, we need every help possible. No president, no new president can promise you that. But I come to promise you and remind you the promises of God. These are solid. It's written even more powerful than any diamond pen, more powerful than any blood. When God speaks a word, it manifests, beloved. So as this new season, he wants you to come back home. He wants you to come back to him and get to know his ways. God is the father of the fatherless, the homeless, the orphans, and those who are downtrodden. So I leave you with this until he brings us back together again. Remember, the promises are for you. Gracias por compartir conmigo porque las promesas son para ti. Hasta la semana que viene. Amen.